हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डीएडी में। होप आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन बहुत अच्छे से चल रहा है। मेरा नाम है गिरीश और हम कंटिन्यू करते हैं हमारे प्रीलिम्स रिवीजन सीरीज़ के साथ। तो इस रिवीजन सीरीज़ में हम कवर कर रहे हैं साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी के करंट अफेयर्स फ्रॉम लास्ट 1.5 ईयर्स। तो एज यू नो, प्रीलिम्स में लास्ट 1.5 ईयर्स करंट अफेयर्स पूछ रहे हैं, ऑलमोस्ट लास्ट 2 ईयर्स भी जा रहे हैं कभी कभी। तो इसलिए वी शुड इंश्योर दैट वी प्रिपेयर टू द मैक्सिमम, सो दैट वी विल नॉट यू नो वी विल हैव द बेस्ट पॉसिबल चांस टू क्लियर द प्रीलिम्स विद फ्लाइंग कलर्स। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। तो इस लेक्चर में हम एग्रीकल्चर और बायोटेक्नोलॉजी के स्टार्ट करते हैं। तो पहले हम बात करते हैं पूसा एसएसवी के बारे में। आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द गोल्डन राइस, व्हाट इज गोल्डन राइस ऑल अबाउट। उसके बाद हम देखते हैं बीटी ब्रिंजल के बारे में, वाई बीटी ब्रिंजल वॉज न्यूज। उसके बाद हम बात करते हैं मुक्तोश्री के बारे में, क्या है मुक्तोश्री, वाई दिस वॉज न्यूज एंड ऑल। आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द बायो फोर्टिफाइड क्रॉप्स, व्हाट आर बायो फोर्टिफाइड क्रॉप्स, वाई दिस वॉज न्यूज। उसके बाद हम देखते हैं सह्याद्री मेगा के बारे में। आफ्टर दैट वी विल सी अबाउट द फोर्टिफाइड राइस, वाई दिस वॉज न्यूज। तो ठीक है, चले शुरू करते हैं अभी। फर्स्ट, पूसा एसएसवी, व्हाट इज पूसा एसएसवी। The Pusa SSV is a new wheat variety unveiled recently by the Indian Agriculture Research Institute. So unveiled this Pusa SSV. So this is also called HD3226, which is a new variety and has higher yield compared to the predecessors. So it contains the protein and gluten, high protein and gluten. So Pusa SSV basically is a new variety of wheat. Okay, it's a fortified wheat, you can say. It's fortified crops, you can say. It's also genetically modified ones. This gives the better yield. Okay, and also this has, you know, very high resistance for the pests and, you know, all the other diseases. So this is developed by the Indian Agriculture Research Institute. It's a fortified one. So it's not, you can not even say it's a fortified, it's a genetically modified one, you can say. It's a genetically modified Indian variety basically. This has high protein and gluten. So high protein and gluten. The high protein and gluten, why this is important is, this gives wheat and rice everything, it gives that fiber content to the food. The fiber content in the food is very much important for us. It's very healthy for us, the fiber content in the food. So this variety has high content of protein and gluten. Next one, the golden rice was in use. What is this golden rice? It's a genetically engineered rice that contains beta carotene. It is claimed that it will be able to fight vitamin A deficiency. This will fight the vitamin A deficiency, this which is the leading cause for blindness among children, and this also leads to death due to infectious disease such as measles. So this genetically modification is being done to ensure that certain vitamins and minerals which are not there indigenously in that crop, this will be inserted in that crop. Okay, इसीलिए all these genetical modifications has been done recently. We saw with Pusa SSV, how the genetical modification is helping it to have more protein and the gluten content. In this previous slide, we have seen how it will have. So this golden rice is also a genetically engineered rice, which has that protein, beta carotene. Beta carotene is the protein. So this will fight against the vitamin A. So golden rice is genetically modified rice, and this will contain the protein beta carotene. Okay, this will lead to cause of blindness among the children and also lead to the death due to infectious disease such as measles. Next one, illegal cultivation of BT brinjal was done in Haryana. So as you know already, BT cotton is the only genetically modified crop that is currently accepted in India officially. So but illegally, if anything is other than BT cotton is cultivated illegally, if anything other than the genetically modified crops other than BT cotton is cultivated, then this is punishable. This is an offense. So recently in Haryana, the BT brinjal was cultivated, it was seen. So India banned the BT brinjal way back in 2010 itself. India banned this. It's a genetically modified crop, this BT brinjal, and it has a novel combination of genetic material obtained through the use of modern biotechnology. So why the government bans such crops? So why the government ban is that they might be harmful for the environment. There are a lot of aspects where they might be harmful for the environment because a lot of research has not gone through. You know, because we don't know what it can cause. Because this will damage the cycle, the natural cycle. Because when natural cycles are damaged, the consequences will be grave. That is the reason there are few crops that the government doesn't allow. Next one, Muktoshri, which is the arsenic resistant rice. What is Muktoshri? So the Muktoshri is an arsenic resistant rice. West Bengal's Rice Research Institute has developed the Muktoshri. West Bengal is the largest cultivator of rice in India. okay, it's one of the largest state that cultivates rice. So it has developed this Muktoshri, and this can be grown in the arsenic prone areas. So this is jointly developed by Rice Research Station at Chinsura, and this comes under West Bengal's Agriculture Department and National Biotechnobotanical Research Institute, Lucknow. So Muktoshri is arsenic resistant rice. So why it is important? This is important because if any soil contains arsenic, the arsenic that it will get into the rice, it will go into the rice, and when the rice becomes toxic with arsenic, this is very carcinogenic for human beings, this is very harmful for human beings, because when the rice contains arsenic and all, you know, this causes cancer and skin lesions. It also, arsenic in drinking water also causes a lot of problems. It causes a lot of bone deficiency, it causes a lot of bone problems to human beings. And it has also been associated with cardiovascular diseases and diabetes. So the arsenic is very harmful for human beings. So that is why Muktoshri, which is an arsenic resistant rice, is very much important. It is developed by them, as you have seen, the West Bengal's Rice Research Institute, and along with the Rice Research Station at Chinsura. Okay, next one, biofortified crops. What is biofortified crops? So recently, scientists of Agriculture Research Institute Pune has developed the biofortified crops, biofortified variety of wheat with a semi-dwarf variety. It has shown the superior and stable yielding ability. It is resistant to stem rust, leaf rust, foliar aphides, root aphides, and brown wheat mite. So these are the different pests that attack the crop, you can say. So a crop will be affected by a lot of pests, lot of weeds and all. So the biofortified crops, what will be done is, they will be modified in such a way that they become resistant to all these threats. They become resistant to all these, and they will have extra nutrients and minerals which are originally not present in those crops. Okay, next one, as we have seen, this is about biofortified crops. What it will do, it will increase the nutritional value of crop. As I told you already, they will contain the extra proteins and extra vitamins and minerals which are originally not present in that crop. And when something which is originally not present in that crop is inserted in that, it will become protein rich, it will become nutrient rich, and this is very important for the crop, is very important for us, in fact, because we are suffering from a lot of conditions like malnutrition and all. Okay, so that's why we have to ensure that all the people receive all the nutrients. And through this biofortification, which is a very good method to make sure that we come out of this deficient nutrient deficiencies among the masses, among the poor people. Okay, next, Sahyadri Mega recently was in news. So the Sahyadri Mega is a new variety of paddy resistant to blast disease. Blast disease is a disease in rice. Okay, so this is a new variety that is resistant to blast disease, and it's also rich in nutrients, various nutrients. It is developed by the University of Agriculture and Horticultural Sciences, Shivamoga. Who developed this Sahyadri Mega? It is developed by University of Agriculture and Horticultural Sciences as part of initiative to prevent the decline in the area under paddy cultivation. So the area under paddy cultivation has been declining recently because of various reasons like water shortage and other reasons like the high amount of, or you can say, high income for sugarcane and horticulture crops. So the area under paddy cultivation has been decreasing, and also some of the other reasons like the pest and other diseases that are attacking the crop. So in order to make sure that the crops are protected, new varieties have been introduced in the market. So this Sahyadri Mega is a new variety of paddy resistant to blast disease. Okay, so it is developed by University of Agriculture and Horticulture Sciences, Shivamoga. So next one, fortified rice. So recently, Department of Food and Public Distribution has approved the centrally sponsored pilot scheme on fortified rice and its distribution through PDS. So normally through the PDS, the poor people will be, you know, they will be distributed the rice, wheat, pulses, and other things, and oil and other things. But are these enough for the complete nutritional requirement of the poor? No, these are not enough. So in order to make sure that the poor receive the wholesome nutrients, that is all the nutrients, the government is trying to bring in this fortified rice. The government is trying to give the fortified rice to the public distribution system itself, so that the complete nutritional requirement of the poor people will be maintained. So the fortified rice, which contains vitamin A, B1, B12, folic acid, iron, and zinc. So it contains all these things, because normally you see the vitamin B12, The B12 will be present generally in the meat and other things, the meat and meat products. So the poor people cannot consume this meat and meat products, and they will be deficient of their vitamin B12. Similarly, the other vitamin A and vitamin B1. Okay, so the Food Safety Standard Authority of India has formulated a comprehensive regulation on fortification of foods, namely the Food Standard, the Food Safety and Standards Fortification Regulations 2016. So under this, recently the Department of Food and Public Distribution has approved the distribution of the fortified crops to the poor people under the PDS system. Now let's revise what we have studied. The Pusa Yashasvi is a variety of wheat, the new variety of wheat developed by the Research Agriculture Research Institute. Next is golden rice. Golden rice is a genetically engineered rice. The genetically engineered rice, it will have more proteins and vitamins. It will have vitamin A, and it also have extra protein called beta carotene, which is very important for the human beings. Next, BT brinjal. Illegally, BT brinjal is being cultivated in Haryana. As you know, only BT cotton is being approved in India currently. The cultivation of any other genetically modified crops is illegal. Next is Muktoshri. Muktoshri is a type of rice which is resistant to arsenic. Arsenic resistant rice. So this is developed by the Bengal Rice Research Institute. Okay, so this is important. Next, the biofortified crops. The biofortified crops are the crops where extra proteins and vitamins are being added to those crops. So in order to ensure that the people who are eating those crops and those foods, they will get all the nutrients and vitamins through those foods. Okay, next one, Sahyadri Mega. Sahyadri Mega is a type of rice variety which is to ensure or stop the decline of rice, the decline of rice cultivation. Okay, next is fortified rice. Recently the Food Department of Food and Public Distribution has approved the distribution of fortified rice through the public distribution system. So distribution of fortified rice will ensure that the people who are consuming the fortified rice, the poor people who are consuming the fortified rice, will get all the vitamins and minerals through the fortified rice. Okay, so that's it, friends, in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.